Okay, I'm going to present our paper entitled Automatic Rule Extraction from Excel Rules Using Generic Programming, that was mainly developed by Paloma de las Cuevas in collaboration with myself, Pablo García Sánchez, Zaineb Chelly, María Isabel García Arenas, and Juan Julián Merelo. Okay, the idea of this paper came from a European project called Muses, where we were participating with other universities and companies. When we get a full data set of security events in the environment of the brand your own device methodology. Okay, this methodology implies companies that allow the employers to the employees to have to use their own mobile her personal mobile devices to work with the company. So we have to find an equilibrium between the personal use and the work use of these devices. So the idea is that the chief security officer in a company creates some kind of rules that takes into account the personal use of the mobile, but also the work use to allow them to do or not to do some stuff. For example, if you connect with your mobile device to the Wi-Fi of your company, it's easy to think that it's a secure Wi-Fi, while your personal Wi-Fi in your house maybe is not as secure. So the idea is we got a big data set with events that happens in this system, and the idea was to extract rules to allow the CSO to set these rules in other environments, or simplify the rules, or maybe to do some kind of reverse engineering from the events of the system to extract knowledge. So we propose to use the genetic programming algorithm using a framework called Gilead in combination with Weka to start from this data set formed by 153,000 samples and 38 attributes and two classes, granted or denied. So when some of these events appears, it can be done or not depending of the rule. You can see in that slide some of the events. We have categorical, numerical, and binary variables. So the idea was to create a set of rules, a rule set, that that allows to predict what to do in each case. So we, as we are using genetic programming, we compared it to two different approaches, the Michigan and the Pittsburgh approach that was in the book Data Mining by Ian Thorpe, if I remember, that one of them is only one rule, one from one class, another from another class, and the Pittsburgh approach that every individual is a set of rules, or in our case, a tree. So this every branch of the tree finishing in a class. We also compare it to different fitness, one that takes into account the accuracy, and another one that takes into account the complexity of the generated rule set. So the idea is not only compare the fitness, but the validate using a validation set of the data set, but also take into account the time. As probably you know, if you're using generic programming, the time is a very important part for evaluation, because it could a blowout of the trees could appear. We also compare different parameters for the alpha values that I will explain later, and the false positives and false negatives obtained. These are the two fitness. They are very well known fitness, also defined in several books of the literature. One only takes into account the true positives and the true negatives with respect to the total. But the other one takes not only the true positives and negatives, but also the false positives and false negatives, but also the number of nodes and the depth of the generated tree. Well, this is the parameters we use at a classical, after a trial and error, we tweak it a little to get a good result. Maybe the most important parameter to comment is, well, we are using the classic subtree crossover, usually used in genetic programming. And also the one node mutation that can modify a complete node or the variable or the range of the variable depending if they are categorical or binary or numeric. Okay, we compared also different values of alpha for the complexity based fitness. And we tested the convergence. You can see the convergence in the Pittsburgh approach. We gave the algorithm a lot of iterations because in 50 generations also it really converges. So, but in the Michigan approach, there is more variability around all the iterations. Okay, we validated the generated model against the training data set using a 10 cross validation approach. And we discovered that the Pittsburgh approach, as it was expected, because it has a wider number of rules, covered maybe 92% of values. But there wasn't any significant difference between the alpha values for the complexity fitness. But we found differences between the time and the size of the tree. As you can see, the time measurement was measuring hours. So the slower one was with an alpha value of 0.5. So it is important, the length of the algorithm. And also we have differences between the number of nodes in the tree and the depth. So depending of the CSO policies, we can choose one or another. Okay. I guess I talk too fast. So the idea of this paper was to present the differences of these approaches. As I expected, the Pittsburgh outperforms the Michigan one. Also, the alpha value does not affect in validation. It clearly affects in different other measures, as time or complexity. And in future, we are planning to apply this to, because we have different objective. We can use a multi-objective optimization, a more complete parameter analysis, and maybe use other data set related to security that are appearing recently. Okay, that's all. When I recorded the video, I spent 10 minutes, but now I think I spent maybe 2 or 3 minutes. I don't know why, but that's all. If you have any questions, I will be glad to answer you.
Thank you, Pablo. You did just good, I think. So for the questions, they will be, I have been sharing with you a link, yes, and you exactly can find for the poster session tonight, and okay.
Excellent.